Xi Jinping knows that he will have to break us in this island or lose the trade war. If we can stand up to him, all of the world may be free, and the life of the world may move forward into broad, sunlit uplands. But if we fail, then the whole world, including Australia and all that we have known and cared for, will sink into the abyss of a new dark age made more sinister. Let us therefore brace ourselves to our duty and so bear ourselves that if Australia and the Australian way of life lasts for 1,000 years, men will say, this was their finest hour. This is not an original opening. This is lifted from Churchill's finest hour speech. But does it not fit magically? An Australia that never really existed on the world's rare earth mining map has suddenly risen up to defeat the biggest rare earth mining nation. Although it is hard to imagine Morrison as Churchill just yet, but hey, give us some creative liberty. Hi and welcome to TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I'm your host Shubhangi, and in this video, I will tell you how Australia is reducing the world's dependence on China as far as rare earth mining is concerned. Let's begin. Human history tells us that when things go down to the wire and two civilizations clash with each other, it is not the size of the dog in the fight, but the size of the fight in the dog that matters. Today, as China and Australia clash with each other, it seems that Australia, with a much smaller economy, might be able to beat China simply because of its steely resolve and will to fight. In fact, Canberra is looking to dethrone Beijing's near monopoly in a key sector, rare earth mining, which is going to define the future of human existence. Australia realizes its enormous potential as a vast repository of rare earth minerals that can help it bring radical changes to the rare earth supply chain and destroy China's stronghold in the sector. Presently, Australia is the second largest rare earth producing country in the world and mines 38,000 tons of rare earth metals every year. China, however, remains far ahead and mines 140,000 tons of rare earth every year. As per Bloomberg NEF, China controls 2/3 of mining and 85% of the refining of rare earth metals. Yet Canberra has the ability to dethrone Beijing in the rare earth sector. With 4.1 million tons of rare earth reserves, Australia has the fifth largest deposits of the futuristic minerals in the world. Given its vast reserves, Australia needs to make substantial investments in the rare earth mining sector and augment its share in the global rare earth supply sector. The most important sector bound to consume much of the rare earth metal supply in the future is the e-vehicles industry. However, China is expected to divert most of its rare earth production towards domestic use, and therefore leading car makers like BMW and General Motors must look at sources outside China to fulfill their rare earth demand. In fact, European automakers are reportedly in talks with Australian rare earth explorer Arafura Resources for sourcing the rare earth metals that help power electric vehicles. Arafura is presently developing the $1 billion Nolans project in Australia's Northern Territory, which could cover as much as 10% of the global demand for a particular type of rare earth used to produce magnets for electric vehicles. In an interview, Arafura Chief Financial Officer Peter Sherrington said, "We have engagement with European manufacturers to directly supply them with material." Sherrington added that he expects to ink deals by the year end because talks have gone as far as finalizing volumes and price. Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison understands simply how critical the rare earth sector is. In March, the Morrison government announced a fresh $1.3 billion grant package for rare earth minerals and the critical minerals industry. The funding is a part of the new resources, technology and critical minerals processing roadmap, Canberra's 10-year strategy to boost the Australian manufacturing sector and adding value to Australian mining products. With Scott Morrison's rare earth push, Australia expects to grow into a rare earth giant and create an industry worth $20.6 billion by 2025 that translates into 10.4% compound annual growth rate from the year 2020. Scott Morrison's rare earth push is also finding support from the Quad, a group of four Indo-Pacific nations comprising India, Australia, Japan, and the US that aspires to contain Chinese hegemony. For Tokyo and Washington, Australia's rare earth mining industry is strategically crucial as China has a history of trying to leverage its near monopoly in the sector to hurt its economic interests. In fact, in a recent Quad meeting in Washington, D.C., the leaders of the four Quad nations discussed ways to improve the supply chain of rare earths, among other issues. Morrison disclosed that Quad leaders expressed appreciation for Canberra's role in supplying critical minerals because, quote-unquote, that is a necessary supply for the many industries and processing works that they operate themselves. The Australian Prime Minister added, "On critical minerals, Australia is one of the biggest producers, but we believe we can play a bigger role in a critical supply chain that is supporting the technologies of the future." Interestingly, Morrison announced a clean energy summit after the Quad meeting and said Australia is really good at digging stuff up. Now, there is a lot of symbolism in Morrison's words. He is suggesting that since Australia is good at mining, it can help the global transition to clean energy. This is a clear indication of Australia's intent to become the supplier of rare earths to Quad nations and other like-minded powers in the near future. Australia's great power ambitions and desire to check Chinese hegemony are no secret. It seems that Scott Morrison is placing his bets on the rare earth sector to achieve his nation's big dreams.